We live in those days. Jesus is sitting at the right hand of God. We are physically, not spiritually, but physically separated from him at this moment. And he says, in those days, they will fast. It didn't take very long for the followers of Jesus, the disciples, to realize that they needed to fast. In the book of Acts, multiple times in the book of Acts, but in the book of Acts chapter 13, verses 2 through 3, it says this, as they ministered to the Lord and fasted, the Holy Spirit said, now separate to me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them. Then, having fasted and prayed, they laid hands on them and they sent them away. You see, the disciples knew that sending out a person into the mission field, sending out people into the mission field was worthy of fasting. Their heart was burdened enough that they would separate themselves from food for a while in order to be focused on God. It's not there's nothing special, friends, about just a lack of food. But what it does is that it calls us back to God. It reminds us. How do you do this without? Anyway, I'll just be honest. Fasting is not as much of a part of my life as it should be. But the times when God has led me into that and called me into that, you're reminded that you are doing that over and over and over again, because it doesn't take very long for me to get hungry, right? By 11:30, it's time to eat. And every time that my stomach would begin to growl or begins to growl, then all of a sudden, wait a minute, what am I thinking about? What has God burdened me with? What is God calling me to pray about? And it's this constant reminder over and over and over again. You're doing this for a reason. You need to stop and pray. You need to seek God. You need to listen. You need to read. You need to do whatever it is that it is. And so here's the thing, church. There's no call in the New Testament for us to have a designated time of fasting all of the time. There's no mandate about a day of the week or a time or a length of time or any of that stuff. And we're not going to put any of that stuff on you, and I'm not going to do that, because that's just, I'm not going to be a Pharisee. But here's the thing. We live in a day and we live in an age where there should be times where we are burdened enough to fast for a time and pray. It's so easy, I think. I was convicted of this in my own life. It's so easy to complain about how stressful and how crazy and how confusing the world is. It's so easy to argue about those things, but here's the thing. Have I taken that time to fast and to pray about that? Have I separated that thing, that part out of my life so that I can be focused on what God would have me to do and the direction that he would have me to go? And so again, I'm not going to put any rules on it, but I'm going to say this. If we think that we never have in this day and age a need to fast, we are not looking honestly at ourselves and the times that we live.